So if you're the type of person that used GSD files in the past and you're looking for a new way to either convert them to an SVG or, you know, cut them with your cutter, well, look no further, because Make the Cut version 4.6.1 can now read those file types. So if you were to import a GSD file, you can now save them as a Make the Cut file or an SVG or any of the other various types of file types that Make the Cut can export. So let's go ahead and see how to use these GSD files in Make the Cut. Okay, so they added a nice new button up here at the top that says GSD. And all you have to do is click the button and a new window will appear. You simply find the GSD file that you would like to import and you're going to go ahead and click the open button. Now some of these settings down here are for the textures so that they import correctly. And if you are not sure what to use, just go ahead and leave it as 300 and hit open. Now something to note that many times when you import these GSD files, you're going to have a ginormous amount of nodes. So Andy, the creator of MTC, suggests that you actually investigate these and check out the amount of nodes that each shape has. So to view the total count of nodes and associated with the shape, go ahead and select the shape, and then you can go ahead and click the little wrench button at the bottom of the screen here and click View Node Details. As you can see, right here is the total number of nodes that are associated with that shape, and that's a lot of nodes. So let's go ahead and see if we can auto simplify this and see if it reduces it any. So with the shape selected, you can go ahead and click that wrench again and then go to auto simplify, and a new window will appear. It's going to let you know how many nodes there were before and how many nodes there are now, and it's going to give you a ratio comparing the before and after. You know, so just think of all those great GSD websites out there. You know, go ahead and check the description box below for some of the ones that we like. And if you have any favorites, go ahead and let us know in the comments box down below. Now you just have to be careful because YouTube does not like links, so be clever when you post them. So with that, I'm Rob with ScrappyDoo.com, and I'll see you next time. Thank you.